A man accused of trying to kill his mother during an argument over money is behind bars in Western Sydney. Sean Johnston allegedly smothered the 64-year-old with a pillow and a towel at her Layla Park home on Wednesday night. 36-year-old Johnston has been charged with attempted murder and was refused bail in Blacktown Court. To Sam Cucciara now on a heartbreaking story, a grass fire tearing through a property in Victoria's north, leaving a fifth-generation farmer devastated.
Dairy farming has been in this family's blood for six generations, and yesterday they almost lost everything when a fierce grass fire tore through. A number of sheds have been destroyed, a car and lots of machinery melted, while sadly a number of calf perished in the flames. Andrew runs the property with his wife this morning, holding back tears while returning to see what was left of it, much of his land still smouldering.
It's a massive hit. Everything we do now will be affected, and we're not sure if anything's still there that we had there, and fencing, and I don't know, it's just sort of a day at a time.
An emergency warning was issued yesterday for this area in Rochester near Echuca in northern Victoria. Surrounding scrub was also scorched, but thankfully no homes here were lost.
No, there's a lot of dry paddocks, so yeah, once the fire sort of jumped the railway line here, we weren't sure how far it was going to go, but we were sort of back in here mopping up what we could.
We've lost baby calves in the baby shed, and a few of them here are wanting their milk. So.
And that's the main priority at the moment, looking after them.
Oh, yes, of course. You've got to look after your animals.
Despite losing so much, this farming family is incredibly stoic. Today it was back to business as usual, because since 1906, that's all they've ever known.
The son of a woman murdered by her estranged husband 4 years ago says he's relieved to finally have a result for his mum. John Edwards was today found guilty of killing wife Sharon in the New South Wales town of Grafton in 2015. Police say Edwards killed the 55-year-old after he found out about her new romance.
Just relieved for mum, you know, like we got justice today. Like, haven't been getting much sleep, worrying about the result, and yeah, I'm just, well, relieved, you know. So it's, we can just try and move on and start moving forward with our life.
Sharon Edwards' body has never been found. A policeman has admitted to bungling a crucial form about the danger James Gargasoulis posed before he was granted bail in the lead-up to Melbourne's Bourke Street rampage. Senior Constable Jake Semmel tried to convince a bail justice not to allow Gargasoulis to go free at a hearing just days before the massacre, but in a bail form asking if Gargasoulis endangered public safety, the detective accidentally ticked no. He says he did argue verbally why Gargasoulis should be kept in custody. The bail justice who allowed Gargasoulis to be freed will give evidence at the inquest next week. NRL player Tyrone May has pleaded guilty to four charges of recording without consent over a sex tape scandal that blew up earlier this year. Charges of distributing the footage have been dropped. May has been stood down from the game while the matter is in court and will face sentencing early next year. More than $300 million worth of drugs destined for Australia has been seized, and a major drug syndicate has been shut down as part of a coordinated international operation. Emily Prain reports.
The international shipment of MDMA was set to be smuggled here into Queensland inside shipping containers hidden in cans of tin tomatoes. It was a tip-off from Australian authorities that led to the takedown of a highly sophisticated drug network operating out of the Netherlands. Both Australian and Dutch law enforcement agencies joined forces to disrupt this global drug operation within 10 months. 11 people, including an Australian woman from Sydney, have been charged after more than $300 million worth of MDMA was seized during several raids in Holland. 700 kilos of the crystallised drug was found in Rotterdam late August. Police believe that haul, worth $140 million, was capable of producing 7 million ecstasy pills that was bound for Brisbane.
This is one of the most significant operations in the history of the collaboration between all of our agencies.
During other raids, officers uncovered 50 tonnes of chemicals used to make the illegal substance.
The syndicate was in this drug business for years and they're exporting globally.
The two alleged masterminds, a 58-year-old man and a 37-year-old man, have been charged and are both now awaiting trial in the Netherlands.
As the weather heats up, so does the discussion about power prices and energy reliability. Live to Federal Politics reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jono, the energy ministers, they're seeking a solution.
That's right. They're gathered in Perth today essentially to try and find a way to bring down the cost of Australian power in Australian households, but also to try and look at a way to make the network grid more reliable. That is essentially trying to keep the lights on, particularly over summer when demand is high. But as has been the way in Australian politics for more than a decade, agreement on how to do that is not quite there. One power source up for debate today is hydrogen. The chief scientist, Alan Finkel, has backed it as a fuel of the future because in Australia there is an abundance of it. But the issue is with making it. That could be done by burning fossil fuels like coal, and already there are opponents to that idea. The Federal Minister, Angus Taylor, is happy that this is on the agenda. The government is working towards a strategy and could wind up putting money towards a particular hydrogen project. Let's hear from the Minister, followed by his shadow, Mark Butler.
This is also an opportunity today to discuss future technology options, and we'll be discussing hydrogen in particular, and also discuss summer readiness, which is, of course, as we move into summer now and in the coming weeks, is a pressing issue for many states.
This is the 18th attempt at an energy policy by this government.
Supply over summer is of particular concern for some states, including Victoria, where there have already been warnings of mass blackouts because of a lack of supply and power production. And how's this for timing? Former Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull today delivering an unprompted view on what Australia should do in relation to energy policy. Remember, he lost the leadership of the party twice over climate and energy policy. Here is the former Prime Minister.
We've got, you know, huge land mass, great solar resource. That is going to become a big opportunity. We will switch from being a high-cost energy country to being a low-cost energy country and a low-emission energy country.
The thing with hydrogen is it can be a low-carbon form of power, Belinda, but it can also involve the burning of fossil fuels, which can be highly contentious. Watch, though, this space over the course of the coming days for the government's response to this issue, because it could actually provide a technical answer to a very thorny question.
Yeah, one we're all looking forward to. Thanks for that, Jono. With just 33 days to Christmas, the Vatican is getting into the spirit. Its giant tree delivered today to St. Peter's Square. The towering 26-metre spruce comes from centuries-old forests in northern Italy. The tree will be decorated with energy-saving lights this year and be lit up on the 5th of December.